Hi everyone, I'm Iris, CEO of Yobi, and today we are going to explain you our main product, Passive Window. And here's the contents of today's presentation. The first part is gonna be our company. Here's the logos of our companies and Passive Window. So Duo-Rest is a single product private limited company by four coworkers who are Iris, Lisa, John, and Harry. So today each of us will present to you the recent progress in each department.
I'm Ethan. You see, in modern days, air conditioner has become an indispensable part of our life. However, while this magical thing brings us suitable temperature, unimaginative amount of energy is being consumed. According to our survey, 50% of all of the energy an entire building consumes comes from an air conditioner, and in summer, this number could even rise to more than 70%. So why can't we solve the problem from its roots? Well, that's where passive window comes to play. You see, one of the most important factors that influences indoor temperature would be sunlight, and we decided to apply different kinds of membrane on the window to adjust sunlight. That's why we made a machine that can automatically switch different membranes so as to meet our needs. So here's how it works. When the temperature rises and hits an arbitrary threshold that would cause us human discomfort that we've previously tested, the sensors will send a signal and the motors will spin, finally controlling indoor temperature through the membranes. A similar process would occur if the temperature is too low. We've also designed this prototype so as to test whether our conception about this controlling mechanism is feasible.
So the next part will gonna be experiment and testing. So I believe that all of you will be curious about the real effect of our window on controlling room temperature. And towards this, we designed an experiment, and during this experiment, we will simulate the scenario of a house and heat source to test its effect. And here is the experiment setup. So as we can see, the confined space here refers to the real house in the real life. And the heat lamp here is actually the sun. So our window will be installed on one side of our object, and temperature will be recorded at regular time intervals. And here's the result. So as we can see, when a confined space is exposed to a constant heat source without any protection for like 1 hour, the temperature will increase to 34 degrees. And if we don't stop it, it will constantly grow and finally achieve a really uncomfortable condition for the human body. And this is why our product is needed. So with the equipment of our product, temperature can decrease 20 degrees in maximum, and it will automatically adjust the room temperature according to different situations and maintain an average of 22 to 23 degrees without any peripheral equipment, and that really improved the efficiency of our product.
Hello, my name is Harry. I'm the CIO of the company. One of our competitors is a company called GLA, which is a manufacturer of passive windows in Germany. Their product has several characteristics, the craft of which is more mature. Besides, the material it uses are quite high class. One of the problems of which is that it has exorbitant price, over $352 per meter squared. That is to say, according to the law of demand, the quantity demand of which must be smaller than that of our product. On the contrary, our product takes advantage of cheaper raw material whose cost is between $20 to $30 per meter squared at retail. The cost can be further reduced to $15 as long as we are able to mass produce. Moreover, our passive window can switch the membranes automatically in accordance to the surrounding temperature, providing a healthier and more efficient way to adjust temperature. Our target consumers include the government and vulnerable groups who have the awareness of protecting environment, and tourism focusing on special operating characteristics for more environment-friendly facilities. The price of our product is expected to be $32.5. In this case, the quantity demand of our product is expected to be 13,000 according to the demand curve.
I'm the chief financial manager of the company, and I will first introduce the expected expenditure of the funds. They are divided into five aspects. First, marketing and sales. We will do the advertisement, salesperson training, as well as the after-sales services. Second, the research and development. We will focus on the technology as well as the material innovation. Third, the management and salary. We will provide the salaries as well as the welfare for our employees. Fourth, the material facilities. We will construct the facilities as well as covering the cost of production. And finally, the legalness and other things. We will pay the corporate taxes as well as the patent application fees. So these are our sources of the funds. They are mainly four. First, the government. As we are now a startup company, we are likely to gain the subsidy from the government because of our sports size and we are a startup. So we are likely to gain the relief grants as well as our tax reliefs. Second, we are now producing a sustainable product, so we are accomplishing the accomplishment of sustainability. So we are likely to gain the research and development allowance, the price allowance, and the investment allowance. So we are also likely to gain the funds from the investors, such as the financial advisor who can coordinate the investors as well as the companies. The financing platforms, such as the Zhen Fund and WeLight. We can also conduct the commercial performances to gain our funds. Besides of that, we can also borrow the working capital loan from the company as well as gaining the revenue from the sales of our products. So in order to estimate the revenue model of our company, I'm going to do a case study with Sola, which is a leading provider of Western windows in the North America. So according to their website, the main material is UPVC, and it is available on all kinds of windows. So the customers can select their preferred material on their preferred windows in order to optimize their demands. This is the matched firm approach according to the Zola as well as our company. So our company is a single product private limited company focusing just on fixed window, while Zola is a leading oligopolist in the market focusing on a wide range of businesses. So our company has a high potential as well as a better future prospect. So our company is famous for its highly innovative electrical system, while Zola is renowned for its specialized organic material. According to the valuation of Zola, our company has a pre-money valuation of $10,000 and a post-money valuation of $80,000. So our company is targeting on a market with all income groups, and our company is a highly trusted enterprise. We're producing an environmentally friendly product. These are the three planned phases of our company. First phase, establishing a local presence. And secondly, to be licensed and to create a full range of businesses. And finally, to increase the investment and the company scale. We're going to become more and more competitive in the market to increase our market share from 5% to 10% and finally to 20%. Thanks for the already listening. Thank you.